Man, what is up, you guys? It is your boy, Six Gold Jimbo. I'm back with another episode of Moto Reactions. Here on Moto Reactions, we scour TikTok for all the funny biker content videos, and we react to them. That's about it, plain and simple. Before we get started, make sure you hit the subscribe button along with the notification bell. That way you guys get updated whenever I post. As of right now, I'm posting about every Saturday around 3 p.m. Make sure you guys also go follow me on TikTok and Instagram. Both of those users names are going to be at SixGoalsMCJimbo. Along with that, check out the merch store. I'm going to have it down below in the video. I got women's shirts, men's shirts, hoodies, you name it. And without further ado, let's get this episode started.
You got a 2-into-1 exhaust and wear Dixons, your bike's trapped.
Shit. Fuck, that, goddammit, that's a 2-into... Fuck, there's a dick... Fuck. I guess my bike's trash.
Bro, those speaker lids are absolute fire. So is that whole rear fender setup. That thing is sick.
Because your opinion really fucking matters.
That is a sick bike. Sick.
What's up, TikTok? So I'm going to address this real quick. I've been tagged in his videos a whole bunch. None of what he's saying is true in any way, shape, or form. This is the perfect example of what not to do as a supporter. You know, on this app, if you comment and share and tag people and...
A lot of people don't understand that very much. Like, being a supporter in the club, you know, your job is to support. Your job isn't to create problems. It's not to spread misinformation, anything like that.
Things along those lines, you'll actually boost this dude's algorithm. So I would suggest not doing that. That's just me. But no, this dude's not valid in any way, shape, or form. And the guy I'm talking about is this guy.
I think we can all agree those patches have not seen the outside world. You see how clean those were?
Everything he's wearing is incorrect. It's not real. It's not true how he's saying he got it.
And that's how easy it is to order fake shit on the internet.
Along those lines. So this is a very poor example of a supporter for any club. Doesn't matter what club he's attempting to support at the end of the day. But you guys have tagged me, tagged a lot of my brothers here on TikTok. We've all told you. But yeah. Let's let this guy hang by the wayside and not give him any more attention. Thanks, guys.
And that's the best way to handle that right there. I mean, this guy just seems like he's an idiot. We'll have to check his account later on. His comment says, I don't understand people. Like, it won't come out that he's full of it. His comment says, if he wasn't valid, how did he get the diamond? Just joking. So, a lot of people know this already, but those diamonds you can just order. A lot of times they have small stores on Etsy and eBay that are making them out of, like, the Philippines real cheap, and you can pretty much order any club's full patch colors. Now, wearing them is a different story. My boy Sneaky Tech's in.
The bike community is not as toxic as you think. Let me explain. So, on Friday, we wrecked my motorcycle. I was riding with about 5 guys that I'd never met until that morning. 4 of them decided to hang out and help me get the bike fixed and ready to ride back the next day. That included several trips in the car to the ER and then to another friend's shop so that way we could fix the bike. So don't tell me that Biker Talk is full of toxic people. There's people in every community.
Man, and you'll find that regularly. Like, regularly, people like us are going out of our way to help other bikers. You know, no matter what we got going on, we're dropping a lot of things to go help these kind of people
that want to talk shit and get under your skin. I'm going to tag all these creators below because they spent their entirety of their day helping me be able to get me and my wife and my bike home. That right there proves that there's no real toxicity in the bike community.
That's badass, Sneaky Tex, and glad you made it home all good, man. The wreck looked pretty gnarly. As far as the community goes, I don't really see it as being that toxic, too. I mean, I know a lot of people get under each other's skin and will sit there and talk shit to each other. I think it usually starts out with somebody just fucking around and another person takes it too personally. So in this video, Danny D'Lo answers a question. The question says, I have a sincere question. I'm a rider, a 28-year retired Army combat veteran. I want to wear a vest that has U.S. Army retired on the top and then it gets cut off, but it says combat veteran on the bottom.
Hey, what's good, man? First of all, thank you for your service. Secondly, I personally have never seen a club mess with anybody wearing a veteran setup, combat setup, or, you know, anything military-wise. I've never seen that. You'd have to be a real fucking asshole to get checked for wearing something like that. And I mean, you personally would have to, like, go out of your way to piss people off and act like a hard-on or something to ever get messed with about wearing that, man.
Yeah, that's huge facts. Like, nobody's going to bug you about that setup. You know, I know a lot of times we complain about putting patches in a top rocker, bottom rocker fashion, but you having U.S. Army retired on the top and then combat veteran at the bottom, we can all clearly see that. We can all clearly read that. Nobody's going to go give you shit about having it in a top rocker, bottom rocker style.
Me personally, when I was in the club or even as I'm out, you know, I've never looked at anybody, you know, like they're a wannabe or nothing like that. I mean, hey, man, you know, sport what the fuck you earn, you know? That's the way I look at it. In this world, it's all about what you earn and being proud of what you earn. So as far as...
That's huge facts, too. I mean, earning the combat veteran, earning just the Army retiree, you know, that shit goes a long way and ain't nobody going to give you shit for it. If they do, they're not even going to be giving you shit for you wearing that setup. They're going to be giving you shit because you came off as completely disrespectful or something to that extent.
As far as I'm concerned, and I think I speak for just about anybody out here, you all good, man. Thank you for your service.
His comment says, as a member of the Red Knights MC, which is a firefighter club, I've had no issues. I've even had 1% club members thank me for being a firefighter. Yeah, see, that's cool. It probably isn't going to happen with the law enforcement clubs, but... This comment is exactly right. Military and firefighter clubs are exempt. Wear it, you earned it. Hell yeah, that's facts. I know this is going to be a good video when I see it's Geek's account and the first image is this little bag. It says, have you ever seen these tiny little bags?
Have you ever seen these tiny little bags?
No. That's something Smurfs used? No clue.
Have you ever seen the-
Holy shit, bro. That's some FBI account coming after you, geek. Big Country says, I plead the fifth. Working Class Hero says, never. That's a small sandwich. Oh, goddamn. This says, Prospect thinking he's got the day off.
This is great. It's a great day off.
No, dude!
Sup, little beach?
Dude, life's a beach and you're here, dude? Dude, life's a bitch now, dog.
I'm here to F up your day. This is...
That is such a good skit. Hitman says, even after you get patched in... Forever a prospect.
Hey guys, quick video here. Just got back from a road trip. Picked these up. They belong to Howdy Doody from the San Francisco Hells Angels. He was in the club from 61 until about 66. Spent a long time looking for these. I spent the last 9 years tracking down former members of Outlaw Motorcycle Clubs from back in the 1950s and 60s. And I have about 45,000 items.
Holy
shit. Please like
shit.
And follow if you want to see more.
I mean... That's cool and all that the history is still there. But man, anything with the club's name on it belongs to the club, period. Like, especially, you know, this member was in the early 60s. So let's say he's passed on. The club might want that for a shadow box or, you know, whatever they do for some sort of memorabilia type deal. Now, don't get me wrong. I feel like archiving it is kind of cool. I'm not totally disagreeing with you. But man, at the end of the day... It's the club's property. Also, did you see the fortress this guy had all this stuff in? I mean, that door was damn near almost a foot thick. Who are you hiding this stuff from?
New Biker Talk Highlights is back, and here we go!
Y'all fell for it again. How gullible are y'all? What?
Ha ha ha!
For those that don't know, Wrecking Ball Bob does these Biker Talk highlight videos. They are awesome, man. Definitely go give him a follow. Check out the Biker Talk highlight videos. Hit or miss, I guess they never miss, huh? You got a boyfriend, I bet he does he kiss ya. Just had to throw that one in there. So that's going to be it today for Moto Reactions. Thank you guys a ton for watching. Remember to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you can see whenever I upload new content. Again, be sure to check out the merch store. Check out my Instagram and my TikTok page.